In the 19th century, we made great progress in health through the provision of clean, clear water. In the 21st century, we will make great progress in health through clean, clear information. Today, evidence synthesis helps us do this. Evidence synthesis is a tool used by researchers, healthcare providers, and others every day and plays a really important role in making informed decisions about our healthcare. We often hear in the news or media about exciting or controversial new findings from the latest study or trial. However, it's very important that we don't focus on one single study or piece of evidence to make healthcare decisions. One study on its own can be inaccurate or misleading, and it may not always give the full picture. Using evidence synthesis is a way of making sure that your views and healthcare decisions are based on the findings of lots of studies rather than just one.
But what exactly is evidence synthesis?
Evidence syntheses, also often called systematic reviews, are a way of compiling information from multiple studies that have looked at the same topic and come to an overall understanding of the results. This can include looking at how effective a certain treatment or drug is, what people's views or experiences of that treatment may be, or their understanding of living with a certain health condition. And doing evidence synthesis can save lives. For example, steroids given to women who are about to give birth prematurely can save the life of the newborn. But this treatment wasn't routinely put into practice until the results of all the individual clinical trials were brought together. It was only when this evidence synthesis was done that the overall benefits became clear, that the steroids saved the lives of premature babies. There are many types of evidence syntheses. However, all evidence syntheses or reviews share the same aim: to provide users, whether they are members of the public, researchers, healthcare providers, or patients and their carers, with clean, clear, trustworthy, and useful information. But not all evidence syntheses are equal.
So how can we tell a good one from a not so good one?
Here are some points to keep in mind. How did the review team search for the studies that they included? Were they consistent in deciding which studies to include and which to exclude? How did they choose which results they would highlight? How reliable, trustworthy, and recent were the studies they included? How useful is this review for you and other people like you? Did the research team clearly describe what they did and how they reached their overall conclusions? So the next time you're looking at an evidence synthesis, try and remember these key points. In short, evidence synthesis has an important role to play in informing how healthcare decisions are made. Now that you know and understand how important it is, what exactly evidence synthesis is, and how it can impact your life, hopefully you should feel equipped in using research to make more informed decisions about your healthcare. Good places to find evidence syntheses written for the public are Cochrane Plain Language Summaries and Campbell Collaboration Plain Language Summaries. More sources can be found at the end of this video. And remember, when you come across a review, don't forget to check its quality. Thanks for watching. If you liked the video, please let us know and like and share it. If you'd like to learn more, check out the links in the description.